Hello, how are you? In this session, I am going to discuss about the anthropometric measurement methods for adults and children. We will see one by one what are these methods and how we will measure them and what are the cutoff points of these methods. At what level we can say that the adult or child is undernourished or overnourished. So let's start from the adults. Anthropometric methods for adults. In adults, the most common anthropometric measures taken are weight and height, and these are normally combined in the calculation of the body mass index, commonly we say it BMI, and it is a screening tool to measure body fat using a person's height and weight. Formula to calculate the BMI is weight in kilograms divided by height in meters square. These are the cutoff points for BMI. 18.5 to 24.9 range indicates healthy weight. Less than 18.5 is underweight, that is undernourished. And more than 25 BMI indicates the overnourished status of the individual. These are further categorized into overweight, obesity and severe obesity. 25 to 29.9 range is for the overweight and 30 to 39.9 indicates the obesity, and more than 40 BMI indicates severe obesity. So it is the most common anthropometric method used for the adults. Now let's see. What are the anthropometric measurements for children? For children, we measure the MOAC, which is mid upper arm circumference, then height and weight. By using height and weight, we see the wasting, stunting and underweight in the children, while MOAC is independent measurement. See, this is the measuring tape for MOAC. MOAC or mid upper arm circumference, most commonly we use in children under 5 years of age, and it gives the indication of the degree of wasting and is a good predictor of mortality. This is a MOAC tape, and with little training everybody can use it. This tape show color coded cutoff points C, yellow, red and green. These colors indicating levels of malnutrition for children. Red is for severe undernutrition, it's for moderate undernutrition, and it's for at risk or healthy state of health, and then it also tells us about the obesity or overnutrition. Let's see how to measure the MOAC. MOAC is the circumference of the upper arm and is measured at the midpoint between the tip of the shoulder and elbow. So first is locate tip of the shoulder, then bend the arm. This is the tip of the shoulder, and then locate the tip of the elbow. Place tape on the tip of the shoulder and bend it down to the elbow, and then mark the midpoint between the tip of the shoulder and tip of the elbow. Now with the arm hanging straight down, wrap a MOAC tape around the arm at the midpoint mark. Correct the tape tension. See, it's not too tight. See here, it's pushing the muscles, and not too loose. It should not be too tight or should not be too loose. This is the correct tape tension. And here we measure the MOAC. See, these are the cutoff points for MOAC. Equal to or more than 13.5 states that normal status of health and no risk of undernutrition. 12.5 to 13.5 indicates at risk of undernutrition. 11.5 to 12.4 indicates moderate undernutrition, which is also called MAM. And less than 11.5 indicates severe undernutrition, which is SAM. These are the cutoff points that have been agreed by the WHO and UNICEF. Now see less than 11.5 indicates severe undernutrition. When we see the measuring tape, see less than 11.5 red indicates undernutrition. Then 11.5 to 12.4 is moderate undernutrition. See the yellow part, 11.5 to 12.5 means moderate undernutrition. 11.5 to 13.5 is at risk of undernutrition, and equal to or more than 13.5 is normal or no risk of undernutrition. So this is the green part, and here at 21 you see these black lines, which indicates that above than that means overnutrition. So the tape show color-coded cutoff points, which indicate the level of malnutrition in children. Other measurements for children are weight and height or length. Let's see how we can measure them. And here you see the height and length. So when we measure the height and when we measure the length. For increased accuracy and precision, two people are needed to hold the child, to sample the child, and to take the measurement. The children aged 2 years or more than 2 years are measured standing up, and less than 2 years are measured laying down. So for standing up, it is the height, and when measured laying down, then it is the length. If age is difficult to assess, then children more than 87 cm are measured standing, and less than 87 cm are measured in the laying down position. If the child is 87 cm or more but cannot be measured standing, then measure it in the laying down position and subtract 0.7 from the supine length. And if the child is less than 87 cm but can stand, take the measurements in standing position and add 0.7 in the length. How to take weight of the child? There are different scales which are available for different age groups of the children. So set the scale at 0. Remove the child clothes, but keep the child warm with a blanket or cloth while carrying to the scale. Place the child gently in the pan. Wait for the child to settle and wait to stabilize. Measure weight to the nearest 0.01 kg. Are as precisely as possible. Wrap the child immediately to rewarm. If you are measuring the child with cloths, then measure the child with cloths and then take the separate weight of the cloths and then subtract the weight of the cloths from the total weight, which is the weight of the child and the weight of the cloths. In this way, you get the weight of the child. How to take height of the child? So this is an example. You can use a board for it, or you can use a wall for this. But remember, the surface on which child is standing should be smooth. First of all, heels should touch on the back of the wall. Knees together and in the erect position. There should be no bend in the knees. Child hands should be straight. Shoulder level, see, it should be erect and balanced. Head and chin should be straight. And then head piece firmly on the head. Then mark it on the wall. And then with the help of measuring tape, take the height of the child. How to take length of the child? It's the same as the height of the child, but it's in the laying position. Child feet flat against the foot piece. Length straight. There should be no bend in the knees. Child flat on the board. Head against base of the board. Arms straight. So take the length of the child in laying position. See, this is the height in standing position, and this is the length in the lying position. Now, how we can use the height and weight or length measurements for children? Weight for height or length. The first indicator which we can calculate is weight for height or length. Weight in relation to the normal weight for the given height. In this way, we see either the child is wasted or not. Length for height for age. Height in relation to the normal height at the given age. So, we can calculate the stunting status of the children. And then weight for age. We see either the child is underweight or not. So, height and weight are used to construct these measurements. I will discuss the wasting, stunting and undernutrition in detail, and what are the further categories, what are the further classification of these measurements in upcoming video. So, like it. If you are first time visitor, then subscribe the channel and share it with your colleagues and friends. All the best.